Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing while loops in C++. Let's get into it. So, we're going to be talking about while loops. All while loops are is that we can execute some code repeatedly while some condition remains true. This is how you write a while loop. We're just going to type in while, then we need a set of parentheses, and then a set of curly brackets. Now, within the parentheses, this is our condition. As long as some condition within here is true, we will execute whatever code is between these curly brackets over and over and over again. But it's also important to add a way to exit the while loop, otherwise you're stuck in what's called an infinite loop. So here's an example of an infinite loop, and this is what you don't want to do, all right? So we're going to set the condition while one is equal to one, we'll display something, maybe a message. So C out, help, I'm trapped in an infinite loop. And then let's add an end line after this. All right, well, let's see what happens. Let's run the program. All right, as you can see, it's just repeating this code that we have within the while loop over and over and over again, and it's not stopping because we don't have any way to exit this while loop. So it's important to add a way to exit your while loop so you can continue on with the rest of the program. As fun as this is, it's not practical. Now, I'll demonstrate a good example of us using a while loop that's actually practical this time. For example, we could prompt someone to enter their name, and we can keep on asking them if they don't enter in their name if they try and skip it. So it's a great way to force the user to enter in something, maybe some information, because we won't let them continue with the rest of the program until they do something or enter that information in. So let's create an example of that where we're prompting a user to enter their name in repeatedly until they actually do. So let's create a string variable named name, and we're not going to assign this right away. So this is the syntax for a while loop again. We're just going to type while. We're going to put our condition within a set of parentheses, and then all of the subset of code for the while loop is going to be between two curly brackets. So what we're going to check within the while loop, this will be the condition. Perhaps if name is empty. So we're going to use the string empty function, and it will check to see if our name is empty. So if this condition remains true, what are we going to do? Let's create a prompt such as, please enter your name. And we'll add an end line after this. And then we will get line C in the user's name, whatever they type in. And then once we exit this while loop, we'll display a welcome message. So C out. Welcome, then the user's name. All right, let's try this. All right, please enter your name. I'm just going to hit enter to skip this part, and it's having us enter our name again. No, no, no. All right, so then it's just going to continue on and on until I actually enter in something. So now, if I want to exit this while loop, I'll have to type in a name, and I can't continue on with the rest of the program until I do. So I'm just going to type in bro, hit enter, and we escaped the while loop, and it displays our welcome message, and it says, welcome, bro. So that's a good example of us using a while loop that has some practical uses. One thing to pay attention to with while loops is that if our condition is false from the beginning, we will actually skip this while loop and completely ignore it and continue on with the rest of the program. So, an example of this, let's say for our name, let's assign this a value, and I'll just type in an empty space, all right? So, what would happen if we assign this a value and this condition within our while loop is false from the get-go, from the beginning? Well, this is what happens then. We just skip it completely. So, in order to even enter the while loop, the condition has to be true then. If it's not true, when we reach the while loop in our program, it will skip it completely if it's false from the beginning. Now, there's actually a variant of the while loop that solves this problem for us, and it's called a do while loop. We will always perform this subset of code at least once, but then only continue if the condition is true then. And I'll give you guys an example of a do while loop. So let's clear everything we have here. And maybe I'll just make a note that this is a do while loop. There's different spellings of this, but it's essentially the same thing. So a good example of this, do you remember from old video games like Oregon Trail where you had to press Q to quit the game? Well, let's create an example of something like that involving a do while loop. So while we don't press the Q button or Q key or enter in Q, we will continue to play this game that we make up. So let's create a string variable named answer, and we're not going to assign this right away. Now we're going to use the do while loop. So we're just going to type in do, then a set of curly brackets, and then after this, we're going to type in our while loop. All right. And then you have to finish that off with a semicolon because I'm forgetting that. So we're going to put our condition between these parentheses at the very end. So we will always execute this loop at least once. And then at the end, we're going to check to see if this condition is true. If it is, then we'll continue with this do while loop. So let's create a fictional game then. It's going to have really very poor graphics, all right? So you are playing the game. It's just going to display something, really. And let's end line. Let's make this fun. Pew, pew. And then I'll ask for a prompt if the user wants to exit. Perhaps I'll just type in or add a prompt that says maybe press Q to quit. And then let's add a get line here. So get line, C in, and then the answer. And I'll just add one more line of text here just to kind of keep things organized and separated. All right, so we're going to execute this do while loop at least once, and then depending on our answer, this will determine if we're going to exit the do while loop. So we'll need to write some sort of condition within the while loop. So we can check to see if our answer is Q or not. And one way to do this is that we could say answer dot at index 0, all right, does not equal Q. All right, so this will take whatever we type in, and if it begins with the letter Q, then we will exit the while loop then, as long as it doesn't equal Q. However, if they type in capital Q, we'll also have to count for that too. So we're going to use the AND logical operator. Answer at index 0 does not equal uppercase Q. All right, so let's run this. Oh, then we should probably write a prompt to let the user know that they have exited the game. So you have quit the game. Okay, we should be good. So we're going to perform this code block at least once, and then depending on our answer, that will determine if we exit this game or not. So let's try this. You are playing the game. Pew pew, press Q to quit. I don't want to quit, so I'll just type in still playing. And it says, I am still playing the game. No, I don't want to quit. You know what? This game is kind of lame, so I want to quit the game. So I'm going to type in Q to quit. And it says, you have quit the game. So you can see that with the do while loop, you'll always perform this code block at least once. And then at the end, we will check our condition. Then if the condition evaluates as true, we will continue to repeat this do while loop over and over again. So that's a variation of the while loop. It's a do while loop. And it's if you want to execute this code block at least once. Otherwise, with the basic while loop, you might just skip it completely if the condition is false from the beginning. So that's this topic on while loops. I'll post all the code that we worked on in the comments down below and pin it to the top. And if you're looking for additional practice or a project to work on, why don't you create your own example of a while loop and a do while loop, and also post it in the comments down below. But yeah, that is this topic on how while loops work in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.